Greetings. Hope everything is going well with you today. I have these really cheap needle drawing pens by Superior. Yes, Superior. Everyone's favorite Chinese company. But they're really cheap. This is a number 4. I think I'll be doing the majority of my drawing with it today. And 10 pens for like $8 with free shipping. Can't beat that. So maybe we'll see if these things are any good. This is my Bee Creative paper, or Bee paper. This is a Bristol paper. It's a 2-ply, 100-pound. It's a nice paper. I like it. It's nice and smooth. It's about the equivalent of the Strathmore, about the same price. It's a local paper made here in Beaverton. These pens are actually kind of cool. They come in this little plastic carrying case, and I think it's pretty handy. I thought I would draw a picture of Paradise Cove and how to really start it. I'm not really sure, so I decided I'd just start drawing from the vantage of my house, looking north from the south side of the pier. And we had a little beach house there, and my grandmother had actually had the house moved to this spot on the beach in Paradise Cove back in 1936. But a story for another time. This is my Aunt Clarabelle's house, Clarabelle Allport, who was right next door to us. And they all bought the properties together way back in the 30s. And her house was above a boathouse, held up by great big pilings. Our house was on pilings too, but it wasn't as high above the waves. And they had a boathouse underneath. One of the interesting things about all the homes back then was most of the homes were on pilings, and they were 8 to 12 feet above the sand, because the ocean would come racing up the beach and go under the houses. So they all had boathouses underneath, but they always had to keep the boats tied down to the pilings anyway. Otherwise, you might come back to your beach house and find that the doors of your boathouse had gotten pulled off and your boats had washed away. And another feature that you would always find outside of these old beach houses where they would have a shower, an outdoor shower, where you could wash off or get the sand off of your feet or whatever you needed to do before you went back into the house. And they were up on these big pilings. I remember the pilings would always have been soaked in this thick black tarry goo creosote, and they would always smell of that creosote. That's one of the most prominent odors that I can remember as a boy, is that smell of the creosote. I remember the big tar would come bubbling out on hot days, and it would be all shiny, and I could push it. It was like a gum, and I'd get that creosote on my hands, and it would just not come off for days. Like I said, this is looking up the beach from our house toward the Paradise Cove Pier. Paradise Cove Pier was a sport fishing pier down in the cove, and it was a picture-perfect spot. I mean, it looked just like a movie set, because it was used in movies all the time, television shows. It was a private beach and a private pier, so they could easily rent the space and set up wagons, and it wasn't near any public roads. We were set back about a half mile to a quarter mile from the road, so it was easy for them to movie studios and television production companies to be able to control the area. And the pier was used in a lot of movies and television shows. I watched them film an Annette Funicello movie in front of our house, and another movie with Jack Nicholson where he was getting his kicks. The bluff that I'm drawing right here, there were some boats on top of it. It was like where they would keep old boats. In fact, the SS Minnow was up there for a while. But when Steven Spielberg made the movie 1941, he built a big two-story house on this hill. And I didn't know it was a movie set. I thought it was a real house. And then one day, I was coming home from school, and the house was gone. It was all smashed down on the beach, and I had no idea what the heck had happened. And later on in the movie, I found out at the end of the film, the house rolls off the edge of the cliff and goes smashing down onto the beach. It took about 3 days for them to be able to finish cleaning up the mess they made. Yeah, the pier can actually be seen, the old pier. The Paradise Cove Pier actually was destroyed in a big swell. There was a big storm that came, and it destroyed 3/4 of the pier. But in that movie in 1941, there's a matte painting of a Ferris wheel, but the end of the pier is actually the Paradise Cove Pier. Ah, coffee. Everyone needs a good cup of coffee once in a while. There were a lot of things that were filmed down here. In fact, the end of the pier, that's no longer there. It could be seen in a number of different movies. I remember The Disorderly Orderly, where Howard Hawke, I think is his name, the evil money-grubbing hospital owner, goes flying off the end of the pier and lands in the ocean. In fact, you can see our beach house in the background, but there's a story about that, but I guess that's a story for another day. The pier was badly damaged in a couple of storms, and they had to put a bunch of bolstering underneath it, and over the years they would put more and more of these boards and cross sections. I remember going up on the pier many, many times when I was little, and there was a little coffee shop out on the end of the pier with a tackle shop and a boat rental. And I used to like to go out there, and all the fishermen would be there, and they had these gutting tables that were set up on the rail. And they had these drains that just emptied the slop just right off into the ocean. So there were always a million seagulls just clattering and clattering away. This little section of the beach right here, this is where they filmed a movie called Back to the Beach with Suzanne Somers. I remember when they were filming that, all the pretty girls running around in bathing suits. At the end of the beach here, or right before you get to the little boat ramp, there's a beach house that was used in a lot of movies too. In fact, Cheryl Ladd, when she was rising from the sea in her first episode of Charlie's Angels, came out of the ocean right here, and it was really funny because she comes out of the sea and she's wearing her bathing suit. She comes jogging up the beach, and I remember the day that they filmed that, she she must have been freezing because it was about 58 degrees or 55 degrees, and it was windy and overcast and cold. A lot of times they would film down here in the winter time, because there wouldn't be any, the beach traffic was so much lower. On the parking lot, past the houses, is the old Sandcastle restaurant. When I was a boy, it was actually just a big, like, barn that had park benches, and they would do a Friday night fish fry, and we'd all go down there and sit. It was always very cold, too. There was a little coffee shop on the side. My sister and I used to go there and eat all the time. It's now actually the kitchen of Don the Beachcombers, so they just took that whole space that used to be the coffee shop and they turned it into a giant first-class kitchen where they could get up orders and more food much faster. Yeah, the Don the Beachcombers, they used to film Rockford Files down here. In fact, you can see Rocky and Jim, they'll be fishing off the pier. Starsky and Hutch, too. And they used it a lot in Baywatch Nights. Those kinds of shows. I remember watching them film in the middle of winter, too, with all the girls in bathing suits would be wearing these huge bathrobes because they were so cold, laying out there in the parking lot on the benches and on towels. I decided to do a quick glaze on this because the skies in Malibu were never really blue. They were either a kind of a pastel, or they were kind of a grayish color. And I decided to glaze this up a little bit with my Winsor Newton stick watercolors. And I found that these needlepoint technical pens actually worked all right. They were better than I expected. They flowed smoothly, and they really didn't skip or stop running. And the ink seemed to flow pretty smoothly from the pens, and I like the little case they came in. So, all in all, they were a good buy. I don't know how long they'll last. I guess I'll just keep on using them until the ink runs out. So, here's the final product. I'm not really that happy with the result, but it came out all right. Thanks for watching.